The following is a video clip from the webcast, Four Ways to Boost Simulation Data Processing Using Python. In this segment, Matt Ozalas talks about how to compute circuit and model values prior to running a simulation. Matt shows us an example of how to synthesize an acoustic filter by using a residual extraction technique.
All right, so back to the presentation. We got three down and one to go. So this last, the previous three, I've really talked about how to post-process data. This has been all about post-processing, right? Basically, what we've done is taken the data that we have after simulation and manipulated it in some manner. Well, in this last example, we're going to do something a little bit different. We're actually going to pre-process data. So we're going to synthesize a filter before we run the simulation and get those filter values in. And the filter that I'm going to synthesize in is an acoustic resonator filter. So these are widely used in RF systems. And generally speaking, if you told me to go design a filter, the first thing I'd probably think about doing is synthesizing it. But for acoustic filters, it's really challenging to synthesize something. I haven't seen in any of the software packages out there the ability to do that. So I spent a lot of time in Python and looked at some of the stuff in the literature and basically wrote a Python script to synthesize a ladder filter. And I actually had that before I built any of this data link stuff. It was already kind of there. And so given that I've got this Python script, I want to show you how to tie it into the simulation. So I'm going to synthesize the filter in Python, and how can we tie this together with the simulation so that the values from the filter just preload right into the schematic, and I can immediately validate if I've done a synthesis step whether or not my filter response agrees with what I thought it did from the synthesis. And just to give you a little bit of background on acoustic resonators, the challenge with synthesizing them is really that they're not one element. They're at least three elements, and so it's usually a series LC. That's the acoustic part of it, and then there's some kind of parasitic-like overlap capacitance. And just digging into that a little more, the series LC, the mechanical or acoustic elements give you this series resonance, and the parallel capacitance gives you a parallel resonance, and those happen pretty close in frequency. So usually these are very, very high Q resonators. And the way that they're built is by cascading sets of them together. So we can create a ladder network by doing a series resonator and a shunt resonator, and usually the shunt resonators are detuned in frequency, so those set the lower band pass null, and the series resonator will set the higher band pass null. So we can improve the rejection of the nulls by just adding more elements to the filter. That's usually what's done. The challenge is, so you can get great, here's the rejection that you get out of the null, so you can see the nulls are getting much, much deeper as we add more elements. But the problem is, let's say I use the exact same element in series, and then I use the exact same elements in shunt. If I did that, I would get a passband response that doesn't look great. It ends up looking kind of ripply, so it's not completely ideal. So to achieve a nice passband response, the filter elements need to be tuned or optimized or designed to get some kind of response. So I don't have nearly enough time to cover all the details about this. This is another area where I could spend the entire webcast just talking about this one subject. But there's a paper out there that I've based this on, and what I do is essentially can obtain a characteristic Chebyshev polynomial with finite transmission zeros. And so I can take the specs that someone gives me and generate this type of polynomial. So I've done that for the input impedance here. So the key is keeping the numerator and denominator S-domain polynomials intact. And then I pass those S-domain polynomials into a separate function to generate the filter. So I start with an ideal Chebyshev response, then I generate a realistic filter with these resonator components. And basically what I do is I use this residual extraction technique where we look at the filter response at each of the zeros, and when we do it in the right way, everything else just kind of disappears and we're able to focus in on a particular resonator. So the output of this Python script is really just we print out a few values here, and that was the state that it was in. So linking it to ADS, I actually start in the data display, and I specify some filter specs, and then I'm going to pass those into Python, and it's going to synthesize a filter, and what it will return is the low-pass prototype response. So it'll send me the frequency response of the low-pass prototype that it generates. At the same time, it's also going to make a file, so that it'll do that in the background, and this file is going to have the elements of each of the filter components in it. And so I can access that in simulation using a data access component and just preload those values directly into my simulation. So all I need to do is hit simulate, and I have the simulated response of the ladder network. So So I'll give you a really quick demo of that too. So here's my schematic. This is my ladder network. And just to kind of push into each one of the components, these all look the same, and they're just series resonance and a parallel resonance here. And in this case, if I try to hit simulate, I'll get an error because the file doesn't exist yet. I haven't synthesized anything yet. So I'm trying to read a file that doesn't exist. But let me open the data display now. So this is the Python script I'm going to use. It's called ladder synthesis, BVD, and these are the specs. So this is the low and high side of the bandpass, and then these are the transmission zeros that I specify. And by the way, I can specify more zeros. I just, in this case, did four. And then I'm also going to specify the return loss. So let me do that. And it's going to go in the background and churn and give me a prototype filter response. So that's returned directly from Python. And you can see that this is an equiripple response. And also, it's low pass. So this is not frequency scaled yet. So when I go over to the simulator, what happened is, hopefully, this file was created. And so when I hit simulate, now it simulates. And that's it. There's my response with all my resonators that have been synthesized at 2 gigahertz. So this is the scaled version of this filter. So I can sit here and now start evaluating the filter. Rather than typing in values from the synthesis to the simulation, we can do this pre-computation step and just have everything get populated into a schematic.